Now we get to do the fun part, which is put this thing in the car. And there's a lot of little detail of things I really want to do with it.
This week on Auto Resto Mod, Jeff takes on the Firebird headliner and Cam hands off the hard work to the old man.
Now we get to do this.
National Parts Depot has an update for your 1970 to 72 Chevelle. After 40 plus years, your Chevelle's wiring is probably a bit tatty and worn. Why not update with an American Auto Wire Classic Update Kit? It's about time you got wired. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford truck and Bronco, Chevy truck, Mopar and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
Well, here we go. We got the inside all finished up and cleaned up.
Everything's prepped.
Yeah, now we get to do the fun part, which is put this thing in the car. And there's a lot of little detail of things I really want to do with that. I mean, there's
little tips and tricks.
It's fiddly.
Yeah.
I mean, headliner installation is not a wham bam thank you ma'am job, because basically people will look at the headliner when they look inside the car. And I'm even going to break the sail panels out into a smaller episode that goes with some other things that we're going to be doing for the next couple weeks, because sail panels are another place that these cars right here are a real pain on guys putting them in. And I've seen a couple of really neat solutions on how to make those go a little easier, so that's going to be coming up soon. But now we get to do this.
You. Your interior. I'm powertrain.
All right, so we've gone in and done a couple things that I probably wouldn't normally do. So I'm going to go through and line out what you should do whenever you're putting a headliner in one of these cars. I've gone in and blacked everything inside this car. Now, if your car is in a lot better shape than this one was on the interior side of things, where you've had a headliner in position, you're pulling the headliner down, and everything looks copacetic, and you aren't as rusty as this one was like we showed you last week, then some of the stuff that I showed you is not going to apply, and you're just going to be basically yanking the headliner off of the bows and then taking the bows down and doing something with them. But before you pull your bows out of the car, what I would recommend that you do is you need to mark for two things. You need to mark for bow position, which is each of these bows has a certain location in the car. This bow in the backpack here goes in that hole right there. Now, I didn't mark that one, but as your number one position, and I recommend only marking one side of the bows when you're putting them in the car. That way you know you've got the right bow in the right location on the right side of the car. You don't need to mark the other side. It doesn't matter, except for hole position, because you can screw up, and I did on my 69 Fairlane wagon, where you put one of the bows in the wrong hole, and you can be amazed at how much difference it makes in the position of the headliner. So you want to do that, and then you'll go in and mark them. And now what I do a lot of times with the bows is I will mark them either with paint or with three's position is right here, and you'll note that I've marked it with a little piece of tape that I can still see even after I've gone in and put the black down on the car. I've also marked the body right here with an awl so that I know that this is bow position three. I've got my three lines of tape on this, so that when I go back in here and put my bows back in the car in the headliner, I'll be able to know that this one goes where it's at, and we'll put that on the headliner here in just a minute. We'll start putting our headliner in, showing you how to install a GM headliner in a Camaro or Firebird. You gotta get out of here. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I've got all the rest of my bow clips in. I'm gonna install this one here. These need to be very mobile. So what I did is I put some super lube, which, it's honestly called super lube. Put some super lube on them. Now you'll notice that I've got red lines on both sides of the clip on all of these going out to the back. I did this with a Sharpie marker just so I know where center is when we start putting the headliner in. I've also gone in and I've removed the tack strip from the backpack here. There's a bow that actually sits on these. I'm gonna straighten them out a little bit more here in a second off camera. And then when we start installing it, we start at this position back here. So this is all in and ready to go. The next thing we need to do is jump up on top of the car and talk a little bit about centering the headliner before you install it. So we're gonna do that right now. Oh, the car! So what I've got my headliner is folded over in half. So I've got one side of it sitting here. I put the other side over the top of it, and I'm gonna center it up on itself so that I can pull a line on it. And what I'm going to use to do this is a graphite stick that I got down at the hobby store. This is a 2B. I would say you should probably go ahead and run a 6B on this because it's just a little darker. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark for center position on the actual listing sleeve here. And then I'm going to lay it out and go all the way out to the front edge with my line work so I know that I've got a good center point on the headliner. And that's that part of it. Now we're going to go in and I'm going to put the rods in here and see what we got, but I'll have to take and lay it out first in the correct position. And what that'll do is it'll allow you to see that I've got a line now all the way down the headliner with the exception of right here. I'm not so worried about that. I'm really more worried about getting it centered up on these lines on this. And I may even go in and use a mark all if I'm doing it and mark this side as well so I know where my center point is from both sides of the listing. I could actually take my pencil here and mark center point. So I've got it on both sides of it. Okay, we are marked up. I'm gonna go ahead and put my rods in. All right, I'm gonna put my header bows up in here. This is number 4. This is my very front bow. And you put it into the listing sleeve like this. Now, what I recommend doing is going in and actually taking the stuff and cleaning it up on a wire wheel like I'm showing you here. That's going to make it a lot easier to get them to go in there where they need to go. Now, you'll notice that there's a lot more sleeve than there is rod here, and that's not that unusual. They'll usually overdo this a little bit, so you got extra to play with on it. We'll probably cut a hole in it if I can get these to visually center up on the headliner. And this is 2. This one actually goes back here in the very back. And this is the very last one of the larger ones. I like setting these things up on the roof of the car because it's going to lay with the roof of the car a little bit better if it's on top like this. Okay. This one will go in first because it's got the cleats that hold it in position. So we're going to do that one first and then we'll move. You can move either forward to the front of the car or you can move to the back of the car depending on how you want to do it. All right, now what I want to try to do here is we found out what the center, we used the centering tape because I really suck at finding center. So I bought this at the Home Improvement Center. They have centering tapes in there. Sometimes you can find them. So what I want to do is the center on this one is 23 3/8. So I want to get the center line of this on that wire centered up with this so I can kind of get an idea of where to cut the holes for this headliner. I'm not going to cut them down here on the end. I'm just going to cut them probably about 3 inches beyond that. I just want to have enough assurance. So let's go ahead and you go ahead and move that. Just drag it all that way till we get to 23 3/8 in the center. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a cut about 3 inches down beyond that in the listing sleeve. I can pull that through there rather than trying to bunch all that up off the very end. I'm going to do this for all of these all the way down the line. On each one of these, we're going to set these where they're pretty much centered. That is going to change some. I'm going to have Cam do the same thing on his end, make the cut a little down beyond it. This will make it easier for us to find center on this thing too once we get everything up in there because it's going to be pretty voluminous, let's just say. So go ahead and make that cut, Cam, and then we'll move on to the next one. All right, so now what we're going to do is going to go ahead and throw the headliner in here. He's going to hand it to me in one big ball.
Because I'm nice like that.
You can do this by yourself. Now, what I've done is I've actually gone in and I've marked the headliner on the ends here to know where that central bow is. All right, we've marked this on the end so that we make sure that this bow doesn't move around. Now, I'm going to take this and I'm going to pull it up and I'm going to let everything hang so the weight of this thing is in the center. Now, you're going to kind of have to make an eyeball on this because there's not a center cleat. Boo on GM's part, in my opinion. There we go. There's 1, 2, 3. You're just going to take these and run them all the way down. All the way to the end.
Does that boo go right behind putting the distributor on the wrong side of the engine?
All the comedians in the world out of work, and I gotta have you around here all the time.
I'm the best.
That's not the word I was looking for. And I'm gonna take a flat blade screwdriver because we're gonna have to pull this thing toward the back as well. And I'm gonna push these cleats up into the top here, which is what the folks at GM did back in the day. So all your cleats need to be pushed. All right, now that's set. Now, you can go in one of two directions here. You can either go to the front or the back of the car. I'm going to go ahead and move to the front. And I'm going to try to center cleat this in. So I'm going to have to move around to the front of the headliner. Okay, now the next thing you'll want to do is you're going to want to pull your bows out and hole set them there. And there, and these are going to swing up, hopefully, into position. And you want to take the headliner line that you've got and center it up on the clip and clip it into place. Now these will need to swing out and up. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. Now you'll notice how much bunching I've got on either end of this. This bunching is going to need to be cut with the scissors. After I get both of these bows set, I'll start going in and cutting, but I want to try to get my center set first so I've got a good tight center on the front section. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this up, get these two installed, and go from there. Sometimes these bows can be a little bit of a pain to get the seat. Now we've got a headliner that's basically in position. We'll just need to go now and center set this and get the middle of it nice and tight to the front part of the windshield. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to install my weather strip adhesive wet. In other words, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this to where it's a little wet on the strip, and I'm going to install the headliner onto it. That way it'll glue itself down over the course of the next day or so. It'll take a little longer, but I want that work time in order to be able to get this done the way I want to get it done. I don't want to put it on the headliner because I have had this stuff actually wrinkle the material on that Fairlane. Seal my weather strip adhesive back up, because I can tell you right now, that stuff will drool out onto the floor and make a mess. Okay, now I'm going to try to center set this. I have a piece of trim here that we bought from TMI. This basically is just stuff that you use on 65 to 68 Mustangs. And I've center marked it to allow me to set this thing dead center. I'm going to pull the center tight and work to the outside edges of the headliner. And then I'll go back and start working the sides after I get the back half of this set. So wish me luck, folks. I'm gonna pull it as tight as I can get it, and I'm gonna try to set this. I'm gonna move across it, pulling it tight. I'm going to probably go in and even have to do this a couple of times in order to get this thing to pull in the way I want it to pull in. Now pull, if you'll notice, a little to the outside. When I'm pulling it, I pull it out and away, putting tension on it. I'm going to work the headliner this way, all the way around to the outside edges. Outward pressure. You want to try to get a good tight seal on this as you go around the outside perimeter. Nice tight thump in the corner, in the center. Pull this out a little bit. Now, that's basically pretty darn close. These sides will need to be trimmed out next and pulled, but that's nice and tight. I'll leave this with the slevage on it until we got everything basically set. Now, I'll show you something if you can see it. Now you can see right here the very tip heads of those screws, making it a lot easier to find those whenever you're trying to put the mirror back in here. And if you're doing this right, it's very hot work because you're actually having to do this in a warm environment. Now what I would probably want to do now is go and set my rear as well to get good tension on that. All right, we've glued the strip for the headliner to lay on. Now we're going to go back and start working it. All right, I'm going to pull the center section of this up. I'm not going to be able to go all the way out to the very... Probably your best place be right about there, maybe. Okay. Do that again. This is one last shot here. Okay, I'm going to pull this center up tight. Again, pulling it to the outside as I go around and pulling it tight. I have to go to the other side now. Can't let it, pulling it tight to the outside again. All right, now I'm going to have to go back inside the car. Take a look at what I got. Okay, now I've gone in and already cut this one down so that it will pull into position. You'll see that you can actually see the button of the screw here for the code hook. And when you cut these, what you want to do is you want to cut them right up against the rod so that you're not actually impacting the headliner itself. And that can be kind of tricky sometimes. And what you want to do is take a look every once in a while, just pull it down and see where it lands. If it's landing short and bunching up, you'll know you don't have enough cut yet. Now, we're going to have to staple this into position, which is why I wanted to get this back corner in play. And what I want to do is I want to staple to the center here and then pull to the sides and then out to the back to get this to set well. All right, now I'm using a staple gun to put these in. You're going to need a staple that's about 3/16 of an inch deep. Some guys have said you can't find a staple like that, so we're going to have to just kind of, may have to wing it. We cut some staples down that we had here in the shop. I'm not saying it's the best solution, but it's the one we came up with. So what you want to do is you want to pull your headliner down and look at that center cleat point. You may have to do this more than once in order to get a good set with it. And kind of pull it around and check positions and see if that's really where you want it. if you can get a good tight line on it like that. Ow! Just kidding. Get one there. Put one on the other side of that. Let's go back to the farthest end of this staple back here and set it right there, pulling it back so that it's a little tight. Now I'm going to have to go outside and pull this back around this corner here and start doing some cut work. And I'm going to have to go and pull my glue up a little bit and re-glue that corner some so I can make this layout flat into that corner. Okay, now I'm going to put a bit of a pie cut right in here because I'm having a problem getting that to stretch. And pull into that corner. And you may have to do a couple of these in a headliner like this in order to get it to lay the way you want it to. Notice I'm pulling and pushing around on it a little bit, and that's to see if I can get it to lay into the corner the way I want it to. I'm going to try setting it there and then pulling it down here into the corner a little bit better. All right, I've got this pulled down where I've got a pretty good line. I've got a little bit of a lump right here, but I'm probably going to be able to pull that this way a little bit. I may have to undo my other staples at this point. Okay, now there's a way to get rid of this right here. You can see some wrinkling in the lights here. I'm going to plug in my hairdryer, oddly enough, and use a hairdryer to take that out. Now, some of that's also going to go away when I move to the other side and I start pulling this headliner this way. You can look over here in the background and kind of see that we're a little bit loose over here. And as soon as I take this line and I start pulling it this way, taking some of the stretch out of it, a lot of this stuff that you see in here will just absolutely disappear and go away. And I may go in and put some weather strip adhesive right there to hold that into position. But oddly enough, I've seen some of these original cars, and quite frankly, it's not really that unusual on a classic car. You can get it perfect, but it's really tough to do. All right, I'll move to the other side, get it done, and then we'll start working on these front sections over here. All right, now what I'm going to start doing is I've done this one back over here. Now I'm going to be going to this bow right here. You notice I've got some loose material in this section and a little bit of wrinkleage right up in here. Now that will probably come out when I go after it with a heat gun in a little bit. But I'm going to try to pull as much of that out as I can right now. Now what I want you to try to do when you're doing a headliner is to pull at the actual bow sections. Don't pull in this center point unless you're trying to get a wrinkle out of the center, because what that's going to do is it'll start putting wrinkles in other places. You want to put your pressure on here and pull it down into place. Let that fold over. And put this up into position. Your hard spots with a pinch weld are going to be places like right there on top of the actual bow point. I'm pulling it this way and this way. I have to go in and play it a little bit. I've got my glue set already. It's kind of starting to get to where it's sticking pretty good. I'm going to probably need to put a relief cut right there, but you can see But if I pull in the center, I get waves this way and this way. If I stay to the outside, this stays nice and round. This right here probably will have to be taken out with a heat gun. This is really all a matter of working things too. I want the weather strip adhesive to stay loose enough for me to use it to set, but tight enough for it, or you know, set hard enough for it to be able to be solid and stay put. And we'll be doing this all the way to the front. Now what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna get my heat gun out and give you an example of what can happen when you use the heat on it. I also don't use heat guns if I don't have to, because the heat gun will actually tend to be too hot if you're an inexperienced person working with this. If you're using a blow dryer with a good heat setting on it, the blow dryer will probably do you a better job and keep you from ruining a perfectly good headliner trying to put it in. All right, you can see now that that spot that I had right here has just completely disappeared. Now I'm gonna go over to the other side of the car and keep working toward the front until I get to my real problem area, which is this area right up in here on this headliner, because it's really bunched in this corner and I'm gonna probably have to pull this down and work this to the outside and work it down the A-pillar there to make it fit better. But first I'm gonna get these bows lined up and set, and I may even have to go back in and rework those as well. Okay, we're in the home stretch now. This side I've already put down my glue and I'm gonna pull it a little tight through here and start laying the trim out. Kind of going against what I just told you for rules a minute ago. But this is actually working better doing it the way I'm doing it right now. I'm pulling away on this a little bit. Okay, now to go into this corner, you're gonna have to make pie cuts like I'm showing you right now from the passenger side. You'll probably need to make up a straight slit cut so you can get into that corner and push this corner in. I'm gonna put some glue in here, I'm gonna set it, but you'll make a cut here and you'll make a cut right here. I'm gonna put glue all the way down onto the A-pillar. Now remember on these Camaros and Firebirds, you have an A-pillar post that drops in. So that's gonna be kind of a key as well. Set this down and then let it sit for a second after I get some glue on there. I'll pull the headliner down into the glue a bit so that I can get a little bit of glue on both, and then I'll start working back here toward that A-pillar. Be careful not to cut too deep. I've made that mistake once or twice before on headliners. You probably would be okay if you went just deep as I did there. You should be fine. But this is where it gets into what I would call the tricky bits. And this gets real fiddly in these corners because you've got an angle that comes down this way, and then you got an angle coming in from the A-pillar. And so you're gonna have to really play with it and work it in order to get it in there. You hear my drum noise? That's what I'm looking for when I'm setting these corners, is to hear that drum. If I hear my drum, I'm good to go. Make my pie cut over here, or rather my slit cut. And you always wanna pull it into position when you're cutting it, so you make sure you've got the right spot. You get it too tight, it could be a problem when you're putting the post back in. Now your A-pillar will sit actually all the way up into here. I think we'll be good to go on that. a little bit more of a nick out of this. I wouldn't recommend using school scissors for this kind of work. You're going to want a really good quality pair of upholstery scissors with a good sharp point on them. So when we put our visors in, we may have to do some readjusting on here. I think we're going to be okay in that corner now because of the A-pillars are going to set in there. Plus, I haven't done any work with my heater yet. I need to probably pull this down and work that corner just a little bit more. Reset this corner. And that's some of the stuff you're going to have to do. You'll have to go in possibly and revamp a corner, rework it. It's just kind of the nature of this stuff. It's the fun of doing headliners. I feel like I'm in a Vincent Price movie with our lighting. We had to do, in order to get you the shot that we're getting you, we had to do the lighting the way we've done it. So my apologies if you're really into that sort of thing. That's pretty good. I'm gonna get after it with my heat gun or with my hair dryer and start working some of these creases out. Now, one tip on this when you're using a hair dryer on your headliner to get the creases to pull out, if you can smell vinyl, if you have that the smell of the vinyl, if you don't know what that smells like, just take a little trim piece off of your headliner, a corner piece like this stuff up here, cut it off and heat it and you'll smell what I'm talking about. When you smell that, you know the vinyl's gotten hot enough to do the job it needs to do, to be tight as it needs to be tight. By gosh, that's pretty. Okay, well that's it. Aside from cutting my slevage off, which I'm gonna wait and do until after I'm totally happy with the headliner, I'll go in and start working on putting things back in the car. We told you before what you'll want to do is to put your screws in. Now, you can see over here, I can find my screws for the visors. I can find my screws for the mirror. And somewhere back in here where Cam worked, the dome light goes in. And I'll let Cam put that back in later because, you know, it's what he did. So, let this dry out, and that'll be it for our Camaro headliner.
You know, if we keep the rear windshield out of this thing. Actually, I have some decent headroom.
You know you don't sit back here. Unless people want to be tortured, no one willingly sits in the back of a Firebird or a Mustang.
I never sit back here.
So, I mean, what do you think?
It actually turned out way better than I thought it would. It's got good tension. I had some faith.
No, you didn't. You said it turned out way better than you thought it would. This is not my first rodeo, dude.
Yeah, it's a headliner. It's not a rodeo.
All right, well, so we got this done. I admit to a little bit of off-camera magic, so to speak. Mm-hmm. I did put the dome light in because I just couldn't stand it anymore. I had to see it in.
Yeah.
And I hated seeing the wires bunching into the top of the headliner and putting a pokey mark in there. So I went in and put the dome light in, and we should probably have done that in what I'm planning on doing next week, which is going into doing the sail panels, the A-pillar trim, and showing some tips and tricks on how to install that stuff. It won't be necessarily a huge video, but it'll be nice for guys to see what your plan should be in the layout of those things. So, because there are some little fiddly stuff that you're going to have to do, painting things and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But I'm happy enough with it.
Yeah.
There's still a little bit of wrinklage in places. Got to take some of that out.
A little bit there.
Yeah, I can't do anything about that though. I don't really like that cleating that they use on these. For an amateur headliner installer, it's going to be a kind of a pain. You have to be real sneaky particular about how you put it in. Mm. So, other than that, I think Terry should be pretty happy with this.
He's going to have a nice view of the back of my Mustang.
Nice headliner to look up at when he goes, "Oh, he beat me again."
Never win, man.
You keep dreaming, brother. You just keep on dreaming. Well, folks, that's our show for this week. Come back and watch us next time on
AutoRestomod.
Have a great week.
You're getting out first.
Oh, man, it's a lot of work to get out that door from here.
Get it up, Jeff.
I'm dead inside.
No, I'm dead inside, Jeff. I have no soul.
That's true, you are a ginger.
Yeah, you're right. And so is Cam.
He's not dead inside.
There's something dead inside.
Oh, you dick.
That's all the rest of the money for you people watching.
Why?
Where's the respirator? Where's the respirator? Oh, Jesus. Oh.